not gonna try to rope her. We're just gonna kind of let her feel this rope kind of come at her. Let her come to believe it's not here to hurt her. Now it's on her, see? We haven't choked her or scared her with it.
Yeah.
It's really important that we don't scare them with it, see? There. And also that we don't miss too many things. So she can start to feel this rope kind of coming around her. See? There's no pressure on her. It's just something foreign touching. She'll find it in herself. She can decide that rope's not killing her. Watch her change. There she softened right there, see? See? So you're making those decisions. Now she's not quite as panicked, is she? Kind of thinking about it. But I guess that rope isn't going to kill me. Especially if it gets up underneath her belly like this, you know? There's just no pressure on her. She's having to feel some foreign object touching her now. It's probably the first time a foreign object's ever really touched her, see? So that's okay. Now it's not quite such a big panic to her. She's decided it hasn't hurt her yet. Now we got it up under the other leg there. Now it's behind the head. But it's just touching her. See, it's not hurting her. Sometimes you gotta kind of let them get up there where they might be a little bit afraid so they can convince themselves that they're really wasting their time, energy, and effort being afraid. Okay. Small pin, reach out and touch him with a 10-foot pole. But he would send the messengers out to the next town and start placing bets. Bring me your rank as wild horse. And there. So right there, see, we're just now. She gets where she can take that whip coming up over without running off. There, we'll just kind of rub on her. Just kind of get out. So she's kind of making the decision to stay here instead of run off. Probably means I'm just going to rub her a little bit and then leave before she does, see? And she's kind of figured out when that rope goes up there, I'm probably just going to rub her a little bit and then leave, see? So it becomes more and more tolerable to her. Now right there, see, I'm just now getting where I can touch her shoulder and her neck. Good girl. Good girl. I'll just kind of rub on her here a little bit, see if she sees my hand coming. Good girl. Good girl. You're all right. Just kind of rub on her here. Rub on her here. See if I can't get up there and rub that neck a little bit more. Good. Good girl. So she has the right to be scared. I don't blame her. There we go. I'm gonna get her to kind of sniff my hand here a little bit. Whoa. She didn't want that human hand touching her.
This seems like it might be a good, what do you think about stopping? Let's go get lunch and come back.
Yeah.
She just might. Wow.
Just give her a little break there.
Good girl.
Hey, your buddy's calling you.
Kind of let down here a little bit and just Yeah, just caution yourself, you don't let it go over her back too far where she catches it out of her left eye, see? Because then it might surprise her over there. But just rub away like you own her. Just rub away. Rub her and rub her. There you go. Just scratch her good.
Oh, darling.
Stay in there with her. Just stay in there, keep rubbing.
Good girl.
There you go.
Good girl.
More that you can do. Have you been able to rub her like that at all? Okay, that's good.